Well, this morning I've just been listening to one of the episodes that I've done in this podcast some time back. It's a series that we're talking about why people do not pursue their purpose. In fact, why people do not do their careers that they were trained to do. In other words, someone trains in education, but they end up in food science and so on. But in the episode today, in this series, we're discussing the reason why people do not fulfill their purpose, or why people fail to live up to their purpose as is required of them, even if they want to. The desire is there, the will is there, the longing is there, the curiosity is there, the search is there, but people just find themselves not putting their hands on the plow as far as their purpose is concerned, to run with it and to deploy it. I want us to look at one more reason as to why that is happening. Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
So obviously I'm going to ask you to do a recap, you know, to go back to the previous episodes, five of them, and look at how we've come far in discussing this matter. Why people fail to live to their purpose, why people fail to deploy their purpose even if they want, they really desire to do it. Why? What are some of the reasons as to why that is so? Let me just give you a few here, even as I do a recap on what we've discussed so far. The first reason we said is that people fail to live their purpose because of sheer ignorance. The ignorance that is pervaded that, you know, purpose is not necessarily needed. That's why you find people saying, my purpose is to be happy. My purpose in life is to be happy. There's no need for having purpose in life. You just need to move around from one interesting thing to another until you die, you know? Well, of course, that is sheer ignorance as far as purpose is concerned. And if you have such a kind of an attitude, you will fail to deploy your purpose. The second reason is big, and it's also connected to the first reason. It is about the culture, the status quo of the day. Generally, in culture, we do the things that we accept. And I can tell you, for the most part, the idea of purpose is not readily accepted in very many cultures, because purpose is an individual thing. The culture of the day wants groupthink, wants people to do stuff that is known, tried, proven, and tested. And for the most part, purpose is not necessarily that. You can review that in the previous episodes. The third reason is the hassles of life. People trying to balance putting money, putting food on the table, and trying to pursue the purpose itself. Given the nature that purpose is not going to pay you tomorrow or in 30 days or in 1 year, sometimes purpose takes a lot of time to pay you. And so people find that, well, I'm a gifted artist, but let me do this bank job. And they immerse themselves into the bank job. And there they go. The time they rise up from that bank job, they're 70 years of age. And the art that was inside of them was never deployed because it was not readily paying them. And by the way, another reason is because when you have purpose right now, it might not be relevant in society today. Its relevance is going to come much, much later on, and I'm going to talk about that at another point in time. Today I want us to look at one reason as to why people fail to pursue their purpose, and this is an internal reason. It's about direction. It's about the best possible outcome. In fact, people fail to pursue their purpose because of lack of clarity of vision. Lack of clarity of vision. You know, purpose and vision are kind of connected. In fact, some people substitute one with the other, but they are very much connected. Vision speaks of the best possible outcome, where you're going. Purpose speaks of why you are going there, what you are meant to do in the first place. They are necessarily connected, because when you know why you are here, then vision is derived from it. Because if you know that you're supposed to enrich lives and inspire hope, then the vision tells you that you can build institutions that can help you, or can build systems that can help you to do that. So the vision is kind of derived from the purpose, and vice versa. The thing is that if you had an idea of your greatest desire in life, something that is bigger than you, larger than you, you end up gravitating towards a purposeful life than if you didn't. It is that simple and straightforward. Life has been made in such a way that we can pursue whatever it is that we want. That's why you hear wrongly people giving you advice and telling you that you can be anything that you want to be. There is not such a kind of a thing. If I can be anything that I wanted to be, I want to be a footballer and earn as much money as Lionel Messi does, or a basketballer and earn as much money as LeBron James earns, and maybe a golfer and earn as much money as Tiger Woods does. You cannot be anything that you want to be, but you can be everything that you were meant to be. And I know that that statement in this day and in this age, by the way, is a very sensitive statement. Because I've said this statement before and Facebook pulled it down, actually it was in writing. They blocked me, they pulled it down. They thought I was talking about gender sensitivity, gender fluidity, right? I'm not talking about gender fluidity. I'm not talking about you being a man saying that you're now a woman and it's okay. That's not what I'm saying. I'm talking about the essence of life, the work. I'm talking about work here, purpose. The things that you are formed to do, the things that you are meant to do, that is what I am discussing in these episodes. I'm not talking about you saying that I am going to be a woman. And by the way, it's happened before. This is the month of November. I think in the month of October in the United States of America, what happened? October 2021, a man or a boy puts on a skirt and says he's transgender and he's become a woman. And legally, he's allowed into a woman's bathroom, and he goes into that woman's bathroom in a high school and rapes a woman, right? And he is transferred to another school because the school administration does what they cover the story, and he goes to another school and repeats the same thing, identifies himself as a woman, goes into a woman's bathroom, finds another woman, finds another lady there, and rapes her violently again. I am not talking about you can be anything you want to be kind of a thing in terms of gender. I am talking about you can only be everything you meant to be in terms of work and capacity. Not all of us have been equipped with the mind of Steve Jobs. Not all of us have been equipped the same. We have different capacities that we can be able to deploy. And so, I don't know how I ended up there. My point I'm raising in this episode today is that we can get a vision for just about anything that matters to us. You realize that if we challenge different people in the same class to have a vision, each and every one of them will return something different if it's authentic. Very few people will have the same exact vision. People have different types of vision in terms of, you know, some will be in governance, some will be in environment and maybe climate change, some will be in human rights, some will be in business, some will be in technology, some will be with children, some will be with religion. People have things that matter to them at the gut level. And the way to do this, if you're going to have vision, is to take that which matters to you and explode it, amplify it. Let it be as big as you can dream it to be. That becomes vision. And the more you pursue that vision, the more you have clarity of that vision, guess what? The more you're gravitating towards your purpose. So let me tell you, nearly 100% of people who are failing to pursue their purpose, they lack personal vision, period. You cannot tell me that there is someone who has personal vision to the clarity of it and they are pursuing it and they fail at the end of the day to pursue their purpose. There never is some kind of that. That's an oxymoron. It's whatever word you can be able to use. It doesn't exist. You cannot. It's not mutually exclusive. Vision and purpose are not mutually exclusive. They exist one and the same time. So it is the closest link you can have to a life of purpose, the vision that you have, the clarity of the vision that you have in your life. It's the closest thing. You cannot hit a miss. If you sat down and clarify your vision in life, you will, for the most part, draw closer to your purpose. You will not miss the mark. You will not hit a miss. And God gave you a heart. God gave you desires. God gave you passion. God gave you emotions, through which you can unearth your purpose. And these things can be amplified to become your vision. So most importantly, God gave you a brain to think. And for the most part, people are waiting to hear from God audibly telling them to do something. In fact, people don't have their own personal vision. I'm talking about not purpose, but vision. Because they are waiting for God to tell them clearly. They are not engaging their mind, their brain, their heart, to craft something that matters to them and clarify their vision from there. What do they want? They want God to open up the skies and give them a burning bush experience and tell them, this is what I've called you to do. It's not going to happen. It doesn't happen. It seldom does happen. And by the way, even if it does, people normally reject it. Moses rejected the vision, right? The guy called Jeremiah, is it Jeremiah or Isaiah? He says, I'm just but a kid. Most of the guys whom God told, Gideon, says, hey, look, you're talking to the guy. I am hiding. I'm the least in the family. The family is the least in the clan. The clan is the least in the tribe. The tribe is the least in Israel. Huh? My point is this. God gave you a brain. There are some desires and there are some things that they matter to you. They matter to you. And tomorrow I'm going to talk about more about this. They matter to you. And as long as they matter to you, guess what? That can become an object of your vision in life to pursue. And when you do pursue that, your purpose is going to be revealed. For the most part, people are waiting to hear God audibly telling them something. And God is saying to them, you need to think. God says, my people perish because of lack of knowledge. In fact, it says where there is no vision, the people perish. You don't have vision and you perish. You don't fulfill your purpose. In fact, God goes ahead and says, God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask or think. I've talked about these things in very many episodes here about thinking and imagining. Imagining and thinking. The imaginations of our minds is the fodder, the seeds through which God acts on. And that is where the vision comes in. So stop thinking and you know that God is going to open up the skies and show you. Stop thinking that imagining, dreaming and visualizing is a carnal thing. It's a Eastern mystic religious thing. God is banking on it. It's a fodder for him to work with it. He told Moses that the very thing that you have spoken I will do. In other words, Moses did not hear from God and then speak it. He spoke his mind and then God said, that thing is what I'm going to work on. So Moses was not waiting for God. Let's switch our dream machines and start clarifying our visions in life. And once we do this, we'll be in touching distance of living our life of purpose and we'll be able to fulfill it. Do not fail to have a vision because you feel like you do not have provision for it. Start with the vision and leave the provision to God, and because that honestly is God's domain. The vision, provision is God's domain. Have the vision, at least have your own vision. Why am I challenging you to have your own vision? Because it is from the core of the things that matter to you, things that you desire, things that you wish for others or for the betterment of this world. That's where your vision can begin. And where that vision begins, that's the path of purpose. By the time you have deployed that vision, the purpose will be fulfilled at the end of the day. Tomorrow, we're going to look at one more reason as to why people fail to live their God-given purpose. Until then. Bye.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.